Here's a secret. The spy game ain't cut out for everybody. Red Sparrow is directed by Francis Lawrence. It's written by Justin Haythe. It stars Jennifer Lawrence, Joel Edgerton, Matthias Schoenaerts, and Jeremy Irons. Dominika is a Russian ballerina whose life is about to change after she gets into an injury that prevents her from dancing for the rest of her life. Her uncle works for the Russian government, so he tries to give her a job to try to help her out. Wink, wink. She is then thrusted in the middle of an assassination, which pushes her to work for the Russian government in a special program called the Sparrows, where they spy, intercept information, and do everything they can with the use of seduction. We see Dominika as she trains and as she goes on her first mission, where she has to infiltrate a CIA American named Nate Nash. Knows that the odds are against her at every corner, she is trying to figure out whether she can trust Nate Nash, whether she can outsmart her superiors before they just kill her anyway, and whether she can carry on the mission successfully with her life intact. So Jennifer Lawrence is trying to have the most radical repertoire in her filmography, and much respect for that. She is definitely the best thing in this movie. She carries on the character of Dominika with her strength, her perseverance. She is an unbreakable female character. She refuses to become just a sex tool for the Russian government just to get information, especially after what the government and her uncle did to her. And Francis Lawrence definitely tries to create this world of deception, of mistrust. Can you really trust this person? Even the main character, can you really fully trust her? Is she really trying to be friends with this person? Or is she trying to follow the orders? Anything can happen. That's the kind of tone and the kind of world he's trying to build. He's trying to make you even feel insecure about the main character you're following. Jennifer Lawrence is great. The supporting cast is pretty strong. A lot of the Russian accents are, oh my gosh, it's kind of noticeable. But the movie is slow as molasses. This movie doesn't kick into gear with the plot for a good hour, maybe hour 15. This movie is a 2-hour and 30-minute movie, and it feels longer than that. Now I understand that he's trying to build this world, and it's showing that the spy game is not as flamboyant and it's not as extravagant as a James Bond movie. I get that. I get what he's trying to do. Not a lot justifies the running time and all the interesting aspects of this film, like how she is being forced to train in the Sparrow program, are cut short. Yeah, we see her train on sexual deception, but we don't ever really see or train in anything else, so we don't even know this woman can even hold a gun or defend herself when the opportunity presents itself. I will say that the opening sequence is fantastic. The ballet number mixed with this foot chase, it just really sets the tone, and I really thought that this movie is gonna be as intriguing all the way through from that opening scene. The cinematography is a huge highlight in this movie. This movie is gorgeous to look at, just as gorgeous as Jennifer Lawrence. Joel Edgerton as the CIA agent, he's fine. A little too trustworthy, very sloppy, very naive, but his performance is nice. I mean, he's a very charismatic actor. It's just that the character is an extremely naive person. Not dumb, but just naive. But I will say that in about 10 to 15 years, Matthias Schoenaerts should be the front runner to play Putin, and he is definitely the bad guy to look out for. He is just, he's smart, he's conniving, he's devilish, but he has this charisma to him that you just, I don't like you, but damn, man, I want to keep you around. And he's unfortunately not in the movie that long. Now, the cinematography is great. Opening sequence is fantastic. Jennifer Lawrence is great as well. The movie starts slowing down, especially after the training. Everything is interesting from the training on forward, but once the plot of the mission goes, slows down, it gets boring, and then they provide you these plot twists from plot twist to plot twist to plot twist that don't really add much weight to the story overall. It's just kind of like a, you didn't see that coming, huh? And that's that. Last thing I will admire from this movie is the use of violence. I haven't cringed on action sequences as much as this movie in a good while, I will say. There's bone crunching, there's skin being pierced, there's stabbings, there's bullets shot, there's car crashes, and it just feels extremely effective. The director really highlighted the violence as something just very terrifying, on the edge of your seat stuff that it's not really enjoyable, but it's admired because it's not enjoyable. It's just very deadly and it's just cringe inducing and just like, damn. Now I know that I sound torn in this movie because there are a lot of things that I like in this movie and there are a lot of things that I don't. And it's because they don't captivate well enough on the things that do work in this movie. But this movie is a solid movie overall. I actually kind of liked it quite a bit, even though the running time is inexcusably long. All in all, this is a solid spy movie, an intriguing spy movie. Pretty sexy, extremely violent. This is not for the squeamish, with a great performance from Jennifer Lawrence and pretty solid performances from its supporting cast. I'm going to give this very well shot movie a solid 3 out of 5 stars. Well, once again, guys, thanks for watching. If you like what you see here, click like at the bottom. Go to our SoundCloud page for our more extensive reviews. This is Ray from LiveWire, and once again, thanks for watching.